FTL's is armed, Falcon 9 is in front of, and is now controlling.
Dragon is in countdown.
Dragon, SpaceX, go for launch.
Send us, SpaceX.
T-minus 30 seconds. T-minus 15. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition. And go Falcon, go Polaris.
Copy, 1 Alpha.
Vehicle is pitching downrange.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
T-plus 35 seconds into the Polaris Dawn mission. Flying crew on board Dragon and Falcon 9 to new heights.
Power and telemetry nominal.
And we're throttling down in preparation
down.
For max-Q. Next call out, vehicle supersonic. And there on the left side, we've got
Falcon
the Polaris Dawn crew.
Supersonic.
Thumbs up from the pilot on the left side there.
Max-Q.
We're throttled back up to power.
One Bravo.
And we heard the call out, one Bravo.
Copy, one Bravo.
That just tells the crew what would happen should they need to initiate anything. But right now, everybody making nominal call outs on Falcon 9. Nice views from the ground camera. And nice view from inside Dragon.
MVAC chill is underway.
The announcement lets us know we've begun the final chill of the second stage engine in preparation for its activity coming up at about T plus 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Two minutes into flight. Everything continues to look good. We'll have, in half a minute, three major activities. Shutdown of the 9 Merlin 1D engines. Stage separation.
Throttle down.
And then ignition of the second stage engine. Throttle down. We're holding a constant acceleration now for the crew just below 4 Gs. See, we're coming up 70 kilometers. Preparing for MECO.
Main engine cutoff.
2 Alpha.
Stage separation confirmed.
Copy, 2 Alpha.
Impact ignition.
As you can tell by the cheers behind us and the views on your screen, the first stage booster now on its way to attempt landing on just read the instructions. Second stage there on the right-hand side of your screen. You can see that the first stage has not yet reached its apogee. You can see the altitude there. Lots of thumbs up there from pilot Scott Kid Poteet. Now 3.5 minutes into the Polaris Dawn mission. First stage continuing to make its way up to its apogee. We'll see that altitude begin to slow down.
Dragon, SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Great news there, indicating
Dragon copy.
That the second stage trajectory is looking good. Now the grid fins have deployed on the first stage. If we get first stage views, we might be able to see the Florida coast in the background. Oh, they're right there. Yeah, we sure can. Once again, our drone ship is attempting to land on, our booster is attempting to land on our drone ship. Just read the instructions. Now the next event coming up will be the entry burn, taking place around T plus 7.5 minutes. This burn will utilize 3 of the engines on the first stage. That helps to slow the booster down as it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere.
Dragon SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Dragon copies.
Following the entry burn, we will see the landing burn, and that'll be around T plus 9 minutes. That one will be just a single engine burn. And that will bring the booster down for a soft landing on our drone ship. Around the same time as that, we expect to see Dragon be injected into orbit. Everything continuing to look good for second stage there on the right-hand side of your screen. Beautiful glow with that MVAC engine nozzle. We can see the crew settling
Dragon
quite...
Dragon SpaceX, trajectory nominal.
Dragon copies.
Crew seems pretty comfortable there at T plus 6 minutes. They're at about 4 Gs. And everything looks good. First stage continuing its descent back down to planet Earth. We can see the crew remain with their visors down in the locked position. That'll remain that way until they are in orbit. Everything continuing to look great with the second stage engine burn there, as well as the
Dragon SpaceX trajectory nominal.
Dragon copies.
We're about 30 seconds away from the first stage entry burn. This is the first of 2 burns that the first stage will perform. Designed to help reduce the amount of drag experienced by the first stage.
Stage 2 FTSS saved.
All right, standing by for entry burn begin on the first stage, there on the left-hand side of your screen.
Right on time. You can see on your left-hand screen that the entry burn has begun. There's 3 engines lit on that first stage vehicle. And this is about a 29-second burn and helps slow the vehicle down as it's re-entering the Earth's atmosphere. There you can see that the engines have now shut down on that first stage. That concludes the entry burn. And the cool part about this with the stage 1 vehicle returning back to Earth is we get to fully utilize the atmosphere. The atmosphere actually...
Stage 2 is in thermal guidance.
The atmosphere actually scrubs about 70% of the velocity on the vehicle. So we use that entry burn to help slow the vehicle down. Then we utilize the atmosphere and the drag from the atmosphere to slow the vehicle down. And then we do have 1 single burn for
Shannon.
The landing burn.
Copy. Shannon.
And next up will be SECO 1, and that is second stage engine cutoff 1, and that'll be on the second stage. That MVAC engine on your right-hand screen will shut down and allow the vehicle with Dragon attached to coast.
Impact shutdown.
And there's that shutdown. And the landing burn on the first stage should be starting up here momentarily. And there it is. Landing burn has begun for...
Dragon SpaceX, nominal orbit insertion.
Dragon SpaceX, launch escape system disarmed.
Copy that, SpaceX, and we show the scene.
And a lot of events happening right there, but you can see that the Stage 1 vehicle has touched down. Just read the instructions. A very excited crowd there. Here in Hawthorne, we've also confirmed MVAC engine shutdown and orbital insertion of the second stage with the crew on board.
Yeah, honestly, a pretty impressive crowd for 2:30 in the morning here. We can see the crew enjoying their first taste of microgravity there on the left-hand side of your screen. Now that the MVAC engine has shut down, they are able to just kind of float free. We might catch a glimpse of the zero-G indicator. I can't quite tell if they've... Oh, it looks like it's in the upper right-hand corner. It'll come back into view here. Once again, they will keep their visors on until given the okay by core here on the ground. At this point in time, the Dragon and the Dragon trunk remain attached to the second stage. Second stage is basically safing itself in preparation for the separation from the Dragon trunk. Of course, the trunk will remain attached to the Dragon capsule all the way up until the point in which we begin re-entry operations. The trunk is what will help provide power to the Dragon capsule while it is on orbit using its solar arrays. Looks like our first clear view of planet Earth there, our first of many for this mission. And the next event coming up will be the separation of the Dragon from the second stage. I believe this view here is, yep, it's of the trunk. We can see it separating from the second stage. A gorgeous view. We can see that Polaris
Dragon
Dawn.
Separation confirmed.
Polaris Dawn flying free into the sunrise. We're now at T plus 13 minutes and 5 seconds into the mission. Next major event will be nose cone deploy.
Dragon, SpaceX. Today you embark on a journey not just for yourselves, but for all humanity. Each of you has trained tirelessly and prepared rigorously for this moment, the moment where we reach higher into space than ever before. As you gaze towards the North Star, remember that your courage lights the path for future explorers. We trust in your skills, your bravery, and your teamwork to carry out the mission that lies ahead. Know that the entire team back here is with you every step, watching, supporting, and cheering you on as you walk into space. We are sending you hugs from the ground. Godspeed, Polaris Dawn crew. May you make history and come home safely. Now words from our CE.
Dragon, CE, welcome to orbit. The Falcon team is honored to have helped you start your incredible journey. We hope you enjoyed the ride. The whole SpaceX family is looking up to you. Godspeed and good luck.
LDCE, message received. We appreciate the kind words. We wouldn't be on this journey without all 14,000 of you back at SpaceX and everyone else cheering us on. We appreciate it, and we're going to get to work now.
Some really nice words there from our tonight's launch director, Frank Messina, who, fun fact, was also the launch director on Inspiration 4, as well as chief engineer for this mission, Jared Metter. Really nice to see some endearing, or hear some endearing words up to the crew.
Well, and with that, the Polaris Dawn crew, they're now in orbit. T-plus 15 minutes, and they are scheduled to spend up to the next 5 days in space. We heard that tone for a minute. We thought we might hear from the crew. But they're going to spend the next 5 days in space before splashing down off the coast of Florida.
The Polaris Dawn crew is the Polaris Dawn mission is the first mission in the Polaris program that will demonstrate new technologies, conduct extensive research, and ultimately culminate in a flight of SpaceX's Starship with humans on board. All of this while continuing to raise funds and awareness for important causes here on Earth. You can learn more about the Polaris Dawn program and the Polaris program at polarisprogram.com.
This mission will fly higher than any Dragon mission to date, attempting to reach the highest Earth orbit ever flown for a crewed spacecraft, breaking the record set by Gemini 11 half a century ago. And there it looks like we can see some nose cone separation action happening. Now, the Polaris Dawn crew will also be the first to test the Starlink laser-based communications in space.
Over the course of the mission, we'll be checking in periodically with the crew. Next up, Dragon will initiate a 2-day pre-breathe process to prepare the crew for their upcoming spacewalk, and that'll be this Thursday, September 12th.
Dragon, SpaceX, nominal dehumidifier activation and service section Draco checkouts, and nose cone open is in progress.
Copy that, SpaceX. We are tracking.
And again, that's Thursday, September 12th for that spacewalk, so please be sure to tune in for our live coverage of this historic milestone.
And of course, we will also be back to bring you live coverage of Splashdown when the crew returns back to Earth. You can stay on top of any potential live events from the crew by following us on X at SpaceX.
And keep tabs on the mission with the Dragon Tracker at SpaceX.com. With that, it's been a great early morning. Thanks for being with us. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you back here soon.